Dear students, in continuation to the last class, that is operations and signals, I am going to explain the operations on signal with some examples or with some solved problems. All these problems are previously asked in the university examination. So this topic is very, very important, as in the part of the first unit. First unit is completely deals with the definitions and classifications of signals. We have been discussing the signals. After completion of signals, we are going to look the systems. So now, in continuation to the last class, I'm going to explain the time shifting on signals. That is nothing but operations on signals. In case of operations on signals, there are three operations we can perform on the signals. One is time shifting, another one is time reversal, another one is time scaling operations. As we know, there are three operations can be performed on the signals. First one is a time shifting operation, second one is a time reversal operation, and the third one is a time scaling operation. We are discussing the first operation, that is what? It is a time scaling operation. That means what? We have one particular signal. Signal is nothing but it is a physical phenomenon which conveys the information, and it is a function of one or more independent variable. Independent variable is t, that is time, and the x of t is a signal. That means what? By applying some operations on independent variable, we can have the three types of operations. First one is a time shifting, a time reversal, and the time scaling. Then I am going with the in continuation to the last class, I am having the one particular signal, that is x of t. By seeing the x of t, we should understand that it is a continuous time signal, in which every instant of time, at every instant of time, there will be a signal. These type of signals are named as continuous time signals, and these continuous time signals can be denoted with x of t. Here t is an independent variable. We are applying some operations on the t. We are applying some operations on the independent variable. By applying some operations on the independent variable, we can have the three operations. One is time shifting, another one is time reversal, another one is time scaling. So that here x of t is one particular signal on which we will be applying, the time shifting operation. So that due to time shifting operation, that signal will modify, and that signal I am calling that is y of t. By applying the time shifting operation on the x of t, and I am getting the y of t, and y of t is also continuous time signal, but this y of t is somewhat differ in time shifting, due to the time shifting. So that y of t is nothing but y of t. We have the x of t on which we applied the time shifting operation, so that the resultant signal we can call it is y of t. Y of t is nothing but, in the last class we have discussed, that is x of t plus or minus capital T. That means what? By applying the time shifting operation on the x of t, we got the y of t. Y of t is nothing but x of t plus or minus capital T. Capital T is nothing but it is a finite time value. It is a finite time value, and so that by adding the finite time value, to the independent variable, we can have the time shifting operation. By subtracting, the finite time value from the independent variable, we can have the time shifting operation. So that from the above equation, we can write the two possible equations now. Then y of t I can write that is y of t is equals to, we can write x of t minus capital T, first equation. Y of t I can write that is x of t plus capital T. From this equation only we have the two more equations, that is y of t is x of t, and y of t is equals to x of t minus capital T, and another one is y of t is equals to x of t plus capital T. So if we have the equation, that is y of t is equals to x of t minus capital T, after applying the time shifting operation, then that resultant signal, this y of t, is named as, it is a delayed signal. It is a delayed signal. That means what? By applying the time shifting operation on the x of t, if we have the y of t, that is x of t minus capital T, that signal is named as delayed signal. And coming to the second case, y of t, by applying the time shifting operation on the x of t, if I have the y of t is equals to x of t plus capital T, x of t plus capital T is, then that signal is named as advanced signal. This is advanced signal. This advanced signal and as well as delayed signal is with respect to the original signal, that is x of t only. That means what? When we compare y of t to x of t, in this case, when we compare y of t to x of t, we can get the signal is delayed compared to the x of t. And when we compare the x of t to the y of t, we can get the y of t in advance to the x of t. So that conclusion is here very clear. The time shifting operation on a signal may result in time delay or time advance without changing its characteristics. In other words, shifting operation changes the positioning of the signal without affecting its amplitude and span. Complete conclusion is very, very simple. By seeing these two cases, we can give the conclusion is that by applying the time shifting operation on the x of t, we can get the either delayed time signal or advanced time signal without changing the signal characteristics. Signal characteristics nothing but what? Signal characteristics nothing but without changing the amplitude and without changing the span of that particular signal, we can get the same signal either in advance or in delay compared to the x of t. That means what? Conclusion is very, very simple. By applying the time shifting operation on the one particular continuous time signal, output is also continuous time signal, but that new signal will be either delayed to the original signal or advanced to the original signal, and this type of operation is named as, it is a time shifting operation. Whenever we are getting this signal is delayed signal, that means what? The original signal will shift to right side. Original signal will shift to right side. Whenever we are getting the advanced signal, that original signal shift to left side. This type of operations we can get by making use of this type of signals we can get by making use of the one particular operation, that is called time shifting operation. So that in conclusion, with the time shifting operation, by employing the time shifting operation on x of t, either we can get the delayed signal or advanced signal. Delayed signal means we can get the signal on the right side to the original signal. Advanced signal means we can get the left side to the original x of t. In practical, in general life, we cannot get the advanced signal. We cannot find any advanced signal application or the example of advanced signal. But in the case of delayed signal, we can get the many examples in case of delayed signal. This is the major drawback of this operation. Advanced signal we cannot get, but there are many examples we can find in the daily life for the delayed signal. So that I'm going to talk about some examples or the solved problems with this, and the everything is going to be clear. In case of operations on signals, we are studying the one particular operation on signal, that is nothing but a time shifting operation. By employing the time shifting operation on one particular signal, we can get the new signal, that is y of t, without affecting its characteristics, which includes the amplitude and the span. Amplitude and the span is not going to be changes. Simply we are changing the position of the system from one place to another place. It shift the right side means it is delayed signal. If the signal shift left side means that is advanced signal. To shift the right side, the condition is y of t is equal to x of t minus capital T. To shift left side, the condition y of t is equal to x of t plus t. This is the conclusion of the time shifting operation. Then I am going to solve one particular example, and this type of questions will be asked in the exam. And whatever I am going to solve in this video, all these are the questions which are previously asked in the exam, so that everyone is very careful while I am solving this one. First question: plot u of t plus 2 and u of t minus 2. So by seeing this one, everyone need to identify that which type of signal it is. Here it is t is mentioned. T is mentioned means it is continuous time signal only. It is continuous time signal. I am analyzing the signal now by seeing the u of t plus 2 and u of t minus 1. We have to understand that it is a continuous time signal. If it is a discrete time signal, we can have in place of t, we can have n. But here t is there. T is nothing but it is representing the continuous time signal. So that it is a continuous time signal and it is also continuous time signal. Again it is denoted with u. U is nothing but unit step signal, so that we know the mathematical expression and the mathematical expression as well as the graphical representation of that unit step signal. Then I am going to write the unit step signal. That is what u of t is equals to. U of t is equals to 1 for t greater than or is equals to 0, 0 for t less than 0. This is the mathematical representation of unit step signal. And so that we can have the graphical representation of this particular signal, see this one, we can write here, we can write here that is about here. On the x-axis we have to represent the time, that is time is nothing but independent variable. This is t and this will be the minus t, and this is x of t. Or in place of x of t, what we have? Then I am drawing simply what? U of t only I am drawing. U of t I am drawing. After knowing the what is exactly the u of t, I am going to draw the u of t plus 2, u of t minus 1. First, by seeing this question, I have understood that u of t is nothing but it is a continuous time signal and it is a unit step signal, so that I am drawing only unit step signal. That from that I am going to draw the u of t minus 2 and u of t minus 1. So this is the mathematical representation of unit step signal. U of t is equals to 1 for t greater than or is equals to 0. From here onwards, t is greater than or is equals to 0. For t greater than or is equals to 0, amplitude is what? U of t is equals to 1. This is u of t is equals to 1. For t less than 0, that means what? This part is a t less than 0, whose amplitude is 0. So that I can draw this signal is like this. This is the u of t. But our question is not to draw the u of t. We have to draw the u of t plus 2. U of t plus 2. So that compare that equation is with the two equations u of t plus 2. That means what? That is in the form of the second equation. That means what? Signal will shift left side. This signal will shift left side by how many units? With the two units. So that the same signal will shift left side by 2 units. How that will be, I am going to explain the same. So that I am going with the small analysis. Then I am taking the, I am going to plot what? I am going to plot the u of t plus 2. And take the t plus 2 is equals to 0. T plus 2 is equals to 0. T is equals to minus 2 now. Minus means everyone has to remember that. Minus means signal will shift left side. Minus means it is a left side. By how many units? With the two units. So that it is unit step signal only. U of t is nothing but unit step signal only. But it is shifted left side. It is shifted left side with the two units. That signal name is U of t plus 2. Then I am going with the signal name, that is U of t plus 2. If it is simple U of t, then this will be the U of t. But we require to draw U of t plus 2, and t plus 2 means this is in the form of this one. That means signal has to shift left side by how many units? It has to shift left side by the 2 units. So that earlier the signal is there from the 0 to and the positive infinity, and from 0 to negative infinity the amplitude is 0. Now the same signal shift left side by how many units? How many units? That is 2 units. So that the signal will start here. This is U of t minus 2 and it is t, and it will be the minus t. And here we have equated t plus 2 is equals to 0. So that t is equals to minus 2. Minus is nothing but it is indicating the left side with the how many units? 2 units. That means what? The total signal will shift left side by the 2 units. The first unit means what? The signal will start at the minus 1. Second unit means what? The signal will start at the minus 2. So that it shift left side. It shift to left side with the 2 units. So that I can go with the here. This is what? It is 0. Earlier the signal is started here 0. And now it shifted 2 units by the left side. Minus 1 first unit and the minus 2 is the second unit. The amplitude is not going to change, so that remaining will be same only. So that we can plot the signal now. From minus 2 onward the signal is there and it is like this. This type of signal is nothing but it is U of t plus 2. U of t is the original signal. U of t plus 2 is a time shifting operated signal. That means what? On the U of t we have applied the time shifting. Due to the time shifting, I got the same signal, and but with the shifting with the 2 units to the left side. Earlier it is there at the 0, now we have the same signal at the minus 2 only. The signal is shifted left side. Signal is shifted left side by how many units? Left side by 2 units. Left side with 2 units. That means what? It is U of t plus 2. Now I am going to solve the one more problem. That is, plot U of t minus 1. U of t minus 1 what? Compare this equation with the any one of this one. And show that U of t minus 1 means it seems to the x of t minus t. That means what here? Capital T is equals to 1 we have. And so that the signal will be delayed and the signal will shift right side. Without having this minus 1, it is simply U of t only. That means what? On the U of t we are applying the time shifting operation. And due to the time shifting operation, this signal will shift right side by with the 1 unit. So that the resultant new signal name is what? U of t minus 1 only, and it is t. Or you can go with the small analysis. U of t minus 1 and t minus 1 is equals to 0. Then t is equals to 1. 1 is nothing but it is a positive 1. Positive means the right side by how many units? With the 1 unit. That means what? U of t minus 1, it is a unit step signal which is shifted right side with the 1 unit. It is unit step signal only, but it is shifted right side with the 1 unit. That means what? It is a unit step signal. It is shifted right side by the 1 unit, so that it is a 0 and shifted with the 1 unit means here onward the signal will started. And the amplitude remains same only. Amplitude we are not changing. Amplitude and the span we are not changing, so that we can get the same signal now. We can get the same signal here like that. Here onwards we can get the signal This is the signal. Now, instead of starting the signal at zero, we are not having this signal. Sorry for this. And here onwards we will be having, that means what? Signal shifted right side. Signal shifted right side by 1 unit, with the 1 unit. That means what? Conclusion is very, very clear. U of t, plot u of t plus 2 and u of t minus 1. That means what? By seeing these two questions, everyone need to understand that it is u of t, the basic signal is nothing but it is a unit step signal. First you have to draw the unit step signal. Then you have to go with the question, what the question is given. First question is what? U of t plus 2, so that t plus 2 is equals to 0, so that t is equals to minus 2, minus indicates left side, and with the how many units? 2 units, so that this original signal shift left side with the 2 units, so that same signal will shift left side with the 2 units. First unit means at minus 1 it started, and second unit means at minus 2 it started. And coming to the second case, u of t minus 1, and it is, if it is minus 1 is not there, it is simple u of t only, it is unit step signal. And equate this t of t minus 1 is equals to 0, then t is equals to positive 1, and positive represent right side with the how many units? With 1 unit, so that the same signal shift right side with the 1 unit. And this signal, now compare these two signal. This is the original signal and it is u of t plus 2, and this signal is advanced to this signal. Earlier the signal is at a 0, now we got the signal is at minus 2 seconds only, so that this signal is nothing but advanced signal. This signal is advanced signal to u of t, advanced signal to the u of t. This is advanced signal to the u of t, this one. And coming to this one is what? It is delayed signal, because earlier original signal is there at the 0. Unit amplitude is there at 0, but now we got that unit amplitude at the 1 only. That means what? It is having the delay of 1 second. It is having the delay of 1 second, and this signal is named as it is a delayed signal. So conclusion is very, very clear. By employing the time shifting operation, on any particular signal, we can get the resultant signal, either the advanced signal in compared to the original one, or delayed signal in compared to the original one, without changing its characteristics. Characteristics includes without changing its amplitude and without changing its span, and these are the best examples for the time shifting operation. Then we are going to solve the one more problem based on the discrete time signal. Then I am going with the discrete time signal. So now next question, it is a question, what is that? Plot u of n minus 1. By seeing this given question, everyone need to understand which type of signal it is. Now we can go with the one particular analysis. U of n is there here. U of n. N is nothing but it is a independent variable, and it is an integer. U of n means it is a discrete time signal. Discrete time signal means it is a signal in which we can have the signal at a discrete instant of time only, at a certain instant of time only we can have the signal. So that by seeing this one, we have to identify what is the basic signal. Basic signal is a unit step discrete time signal. Unit step discrete time signal, already we have studied in the earlier classes. U of n is equals to 1 for n greater than or is equals to 0, 0 for n less than 0. First try to draw the u of n. After that you can go with the u of n minus 1. So that I am going to draw the u of n now. U of n is nothing but what? It is a discrete time signal, and in which we can have the signal at the discrete instant of time only. So that I am drawing the discrete unit step signal, and discrete unit step signal is denoted with U of n, and where n is an integer, always we can take independent variable on x-axis, and the amplitude of the signal must be taken on y-axis. If it is n, and this will be the minus n. According to the given mathematical representation of the signal, we can plot the signal is like this. For n is greater than or is equals to 0, n is greater than or is equals to 0, whose amplitude is 1, but the n is in discrete in nature, it is an integer values only, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here also it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. That means what? For all the n values, if the n is an integer and the positive whose amplitude is 1, so that here I can call it is 1. At 0 onwards, whose amplitude is 1? This is 1. This is 1. This is 1. For negative values, for n less than 0, whose amplitude is 0? So that 0 amplitude is 0. Like this, this is what it is, a discrete time. It is a discrete time unit step signal, and by using this discrete time unit step signal, we have to plot u of n minus 1. Then I'm going to plot the u of n minus 1. That u of n minus 1 will be like this set. First go with the u of n minus 1, and here by seeing u of n minus 1, it is a discrete time. Basic signal is it is a discrete time unit step signal. But we have to plot u of n minus 3, and n minus 3 is equals to 0. So that n is equals to what? Plus 3. Plus is nothing but it shift right side by how many units? With the 3 unit. With the 3 units it shift. This is the original signal. It shift right side with the 3 units. Then the resultant signal will be, it is u of n minus 3, and it is n. It shift 3 units to the right side, so that we can call it is the delayed signal. 3 units means what? Earlier signal is there at the 0 onwards, 0, 1, 2, 3 onwards it is there, but the signal shifted right side with the 3 units. 3 units means the signal will start at the 3. There is no signal now at 0, there is no signal at 1, there is no signal at 2. The signal shifted to the third one. This is 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So that the signal is shifted right side. Signal, same signal is shifted the right side with the 3 units whose amplitude is 1 only. Here the amplitude is 1. Here the amplitude is 1. Like that, it is having the signal. That means what? Now compare these two signals. This is the original signal, that is u of n. By applying the time shifting operation on u of t, we got the new signal, that is u of n minus 3. And n minus 3 means, if you go with the condition, that is n minus 3, this signal is, it is a delayed signal. This signal is there from 0 onward, but that this signal is there from the 3 onward, so that it is having the delay of 3 seconds. So that if you compare these two, and this will be the delayed signal, delayed in time of 3 seconds for unit step discrete time signal. That means what? By seeing u of n minus 3, first we should identify what is the basic signal. Basic signal here is unit step discrete time signal. You have to define that one, and you have to plot the graphical representation of that u of n. Then after that, you have to take the question, that is u of n minus 3. We have to equate n minus 3 is equals to 0, so that n is equals to positive 3. Positive means it shift right side by the 3 units, so that by taking this one, we have to shift the signal 3 units. If you shift in one unit, the 0 will be moved to 1. Then if you shift a second time, and that 1 will be moved to 2. And again, if we shift one more time, that completely signal will start at the third second onward. So that if you compare these two signals, we can get the delayed signal with the 3 seconds. The basic signal here is that is unit step signal only. And by discussing one more example, I am going to close this session, and with that the time shifting operation will be closed without leaving any doubts. So that, students, from this we can expect the one short answer, one long answer question. And if you are good at the 3 operations which is going to be performed on signal, that is time shifting, time reversal, time scaling, we can expect the one long answer question from this topic. So that everyone is very careful about this topic. Then I am going with the plot x of t plus 2 for the following signal. That means what? Here the signal is already given. Signal is given. For that we have to plot x of t plus 2. For that we have to plot the x of t plus 2. First take the x of t we have, x of t already, that is given in the question itself only, this is x of t only. See that signal is given, this is x of t and this is a independent variable t and this one is a minus t. And this is a signal. For this, we have to plot the x of t plus 2. Take the x of t plus 2 now, we have to plot what? X of t plus 2, and t plus 2 is equals to 0. Then t is equals to what? Minus 2u. Minus indicates left side with the how many units? With the 2 units. So that this signal will shift left side with the 2 units. Then the resultant signal we can call it is x of t plus 2. This signal shift right side with the 2 units. It shift first unit, the signal will start here. It shift to second unit, the signal will completely start here. That means what? This complete signal will shift to first unit here and the second unit from here onwards. So that what is the span of the signal? That is 4 units, here to here 1, 2, 3 and 4. That span will be same, and the amplitude of the signal is also same. Here the amplitude of the signal is 3, here 2 and this is 0. And here the span is what? That is 2, minus 2, 2, plus 2, that is 4. So that this span is 4 seconds. So that I am going to have the x of t plus 2 and this t is equals to minus 2. Minus indicated is left side. It shifts the left side with the 2 units. So that resultant signal will be like this. Resultant signal is very, very clear that here this is like this. Same signal we have, but compared to the original signal, we got the signal in advance to that signal, so that if you compare these two signals, the signal characteristics, we didn't change the signal characteristic, we didn't change the signal characteristic, simply we changed the position of the signal from one place to another place. If we change the position from original place to left side, that signal is named as advanced signal. If we change the signal position from original place to the right side, that signal is named as delayed signal. Now we change the position of the signal to the left side, so that this signal is nothing but it is advanced in time and to the x of t. And this type of questions will be asked in the exam, so that everyone is very, very careful about the time shifting operation. I am giving the conclusion of the time shifting operation here. Time shifting operation is one of the operation which is performed on the independent variable of the signal. That independent variable may be anything, that may be time, pressure or the distance, space or everything. And we can apply the time shifting operation in the discrete time signals and as well as continuous time signals. And in the discrete time signals also you can give the conclusion that here, for example, x of n is a original signal, it is a discrete time signal on which we will be applying the time shifting operation So that resultant signal will be, that is y of n, y of n, and the y of n is equals to what we can call, y of n is equals to, we can have the two, we can have x of n plus r minus k. I can write here x of t is a continuous time signal on which we applied the time shifting operation, so that we got y of t is equals to x of t plus r minus t. In similar to that, we got here x of n is a discrete time signal on which we applied the time shifting operation, then we got the y of n, then y of n is equals to x of n plus r minus k, and from this we can write the two equation, that is x of n plus k and next one r x of n minus k. And if we get this one, this signal is nothing but it is the advanced signal, advanced in time. It is similar to this one only. See x and it is n in place of n we have the t plus in place of k we have the 2, so that it is advanced signal. And if we have the signal by applying the time shifting operation, that is y of n is equals to x of n minus k, and so that signal is named as delayed in time signal. Likewise, the conclusion is very simple in the time shifting operation. By employing the time shifting operations on the signals, we can get the either advanced in time or the delayed in time. But in the practical, we cannot find any example for the advanced signal, but we can find the example for the delayed signal in daily life. This is the conclusion for the time shifting operation. In the next class, I am going to explain the remaining two operations, which are nothing but time reversal and as well as time scaling operation. And in the exam, you can be asked to solve one question which includes the time shifting operation, that means this part, and the time reversal operation, that is going to be discussed in the next class, and the time scaling operation. And with that complete, you can claim about the 10 marks. Questions will be like this. Plot u of 3t minus 3t plus 2. So far we have discussed what? Plotting of t plus 2 only. But what are the additional things we have? In the given question, additional things we have, that is negative we have, and again it is multiplied with 3. Negative is nothing but it is one operation, that is time reversal operation, and multiplying with the 3, that is called, it is a time scaling operation. That means what? Adding 3, t plus 2, it is nothing but it is a time shifting operation. That means what? We have to study the two more operations for the operations on signals, so that if you are good at that two more operations on the signals, then you can able to solve the any question which may ask in the exam based on the topic, that is operations on signals. So that this is very, very important, and so that concentrate more on this particular topic, that is operations on signals. Dear students, if you really find my videos are interesting, you can share my videos to your friends who are studying their BA in some other college also. No issues at all. If you find these lectures are good, then only you can forward, and you can tell them to subscribe this videos or channel, and such that they can have the direct accessing for my videos. Thank you, students. Thank you so much.